So, in my last video, I mentioned that I'd been distracted from working on my 6-input hot end by having to change one of the boards. That proved to be much more work than I anticipated, so this is just a quick video to show what was involved. So the background to the story is that I had two 3HC Duet expansion boards running the extruders. So three extruders connected to each one, and they were mounted on the extruder gantry. And one of those expansion boards expired. So being short of cash, I contacted the Duet guys and asked if there was anything they could do to help me out a bit. Which they duly did by sending me a 6HC mainboard. So the deal was that we agreed that a 6HC had never been used as an expansion board. In theory it was possible, but there were some known firmware issues and some probably unknown firmware issues that would need to be addressed. So the deal was they gave me the board for nothing, and then I grafted it onto my machine, and then we worked together to sort out any firmware issues or other problems, which we've duly done, and it's all working now. So the original expansion boards look like this. I was never entirely happy with that arrangement because it makes it a bit awkward to get any of the to get the extruders and the connectors on the board. I made it so that the boards will actually kind of hinge down or hinge up so you can get the connectors, and you don't need to get the connectors very often. But yeah, still not very happy with it. Although I wanted to put the boards close to the motors, keep the wiring short and so forth. So then I looked at the 6HC and thought, how the hell can I fit that on the extruder gantry? And couldn't come up with any viable way of doing it. Now the other thing about my printer is that I had fitted a third XY gantry called the AB gantry at the top of the machine, which was a load balancing gantry, so it just had a container with lumps of lead in it, and the motor directions were reversed, so it did the exact opposite of whatever the hot end did. So it worked quite well in terms of stabilizing the printer, but even if the printer rocked around a bit, the entire printer, the bed and everything, all rocked around at the same amount. So there was never an issue with print quality. So in that respect, it was a bit of a solution to a problem that didn't really exist. And I've been meaning to do away with it for a while, just haven't got around to it. So I decided to hang the 6HC board off of that gantry, but I didn't want it to be a driven gantry, because if it gets out of sync, I mean, when it was an AB gantry, there was no coupling between that gantry and the others, so if it got out of sync or anything went wrong or it didn't get honed properly, it wouldn't be a problem. But with having cables connecting from the hot end to the control board, I didn't want it powered, because if it got out of sync, it's just going to tear those cables out and cause all sorts of mayhem. But the board itself being very light, I just sort of realised it could be just passively dragged around by the hot end. Just the hot end would just pull on the cables and move it around. But obviously I would need some strain relief so it didn't strain the connectors. So that's what I did. I took the motors off the AB gantry and made new gantry plates. Took all the belts and pulleys and everything else off. But it did mean that there were some frame members in the way that I had to remove. So I had to dismantle part of the frame and take that apart, as well as take the motors off and the belts and the pulleys and the idlers and everything else. So before I started tearing the machine about, I made the gantry plates I was going to need, and the actual mount for the board itself, which I printed in ABS. So here's a picture of the plates that I made out of aluminium and the motor mount. And then I set about tearing the printer apart, and here is what it looked like. There was a point where I wondered if this thing was ever going to work again. But anyway, we got there. So after extending all the wires and so forth, here's how the extruder gantry now looks. So the no more expansion boards on it. Here's a new board mounted on what was the old AB gantry. And here are some pictures showing how it all works together. You can see I was thinking about the strain relief for the connectors and the coolant pipes when I designed the gantry plate and the board mount, so the pipes can go through holes that were put there for that purpose. The cables are all flexible silicon, and they go up and loop over through that groove in the side and then connect up to the connector, so in a kind of an S shape, which gives me the strain relief. I thought I was originally was going to cable tie them to the slot, but it doesn't need to be. So the board just gets dragged around by those cables, but there's no strain on the connectors or anything. It's all working well. So that's it, just a short video really to explain part of the reason why I got distracted in working on my hot end. You can see it's quite a lot of work. It is all working now. We've sorted out all the bugs and so forth. So if anybody in the future wants to use a 6HC main board as an expansion board, it can be done, and the firmware and everything is pretty much sorted. I'll continue to monitor the situation, and if any other glitches or bugs come up, I'll report them back to the Duet guys and they'll no doubt sort it out. So although the board cost me nothing, I had to buy materials to make the gantry plates out of, and cable and cable ties and heat shrink and cable braid and connectors and all that sort of stuff. So it did cost me a few bob. So as ever, if anybody feels inclined to support me in any way, there's links to my PayPal and Patreon accounts down below, and anything would be gratefully received. So that's it. Till next time, thank you.